Right, so here we are. So in this video we're going to mould up this fossil. This fossil is apparently around 500 million years old, and it's of the Ammonite variety, and I picked that up a while back, and I'd like to replicate these and cast them in concrete, or maybe other materials, but primarily concrete. So yeah, we'll get started and we're going to latex this fossil. We're going to make a latex mould. And so first of all, we want to prepare the object, and in this case obviously as a fossil, for moulding. So I've already put a base around the edge of the fossil, which I don't know if you can see there. It's a little bit of plasticine just to seal in the bottom edges and kind of tidy it up and give it something to rest on when the casts are done. I'm going to have to put in a short seam along the side, so that's going to be the hardest part of moulding this. But anyway, like I say, I put the clay base in, just run some clay around the edge and squeeze that in and run it all around the fossil, and I stippled it with a paintbrush also, just to kind of blend it in with the rock. And so I'll give it some kind of texture, and just to seal it in. So yeah, the next step is to put the seam on. So what I'm going to do here, I'm actually going to use some of the plasticine as well, just to hold my seam. I'm going to cut up the front cover of this magazine, and also use a profile gauge to help us out with following the profile of this part of the fossil. Right, so first off then, let's measure where we're going to put this seam and get the profile. So I think there will be good. So just push that in. Use your fingers. I'm not actually getting right down to the bottom, so I'll have to adjust that. So there we are, we've got our shape there. I'm now going to put this onto the magazine, and I'll draw that out onto the magazine with a pen. I'll just move that out of the way so you can see what I'm doing. Cut this template out with a sharp knife. And that should fit where we measured the profile. So I'm going to back this up with a bit of plasticine behind the seam, and then we'll stick it in place with the latex. So I've got the plasticine clay here, and I'm just going to stick the seam roughly in place. I think I'll cut the bottom off of that. So here it goes. I'm just going to put a bit of tape over where those two seams meet, or seam templates. Just check if everything's relatively flat. And I'm also going to apply some PVA glue, PVA wood glue, to the seam to help the seam template not stick to the latex, or so we can peel it apart easier. So here we go with the glue. Like that, we'll wait for the PVA glue to dry before applying the coats of latex. Right, now I'm gonna dab some latex around where the seam meets the fossil. I think really it might be better to use some plastic as this seam template, so I should probably use plastic the next time I do one of these. Anyway, here it goes. I'm just going to glue that in with the latex. Alright, so we'll let that dry and we'll come back and continue building up some layers. Right, so that coat of latex is set. I'm going to take the clay off from the other side, and we're going to PVA the other side of the seam template. So I'll just get the clay off first of all. Right, so I've taken the clay away, and now I'm just going to put a layer of PVA on this side of the seam, the reverse side of the seam. Let that dry, and then we'll just coat the whole sculpture with latex. Right, okay, we'll let that dry and then we'll start putting the latex layers over the top of the fossil and the seam. Right, so now we'll coat the other side of the fossil, of the seam, I should say, and we'll start layering up layers of latex on the fossil too. Right, so there we are. Then I stippled on the first coat. I shall stipple on the second coat, and then we'll put in total 30 layers of latex over this fossil. Right, so here goes with the final layer of latex. So this is the 30th coat. And once we've applied this coat, we'll let it dry and set, and then we'll put a fibreglass mother mold over the top of the latex to hold it in place. So that'll be a multi-piece fibreglass mold. I've been practicing on my fibreglass molds now, so I know what I'm well sort of know what I'm doing now. So I'll do another video of making up the mother mold, and another separate video casting the fossil with concrete, and then perhaps another video creating some paint effects for the concrete casted fossils. Right, so I've got a fan going to help dry the latex. during the moulding process here, I used some of this fibre here, which is a good tip from the folks at DIYmoulds.com. So thank you for that, for everybody who gave that advice. And I think that's about it. So yeah, the fibres, you can soak them in latex and then apply it to the mould. I tend to put a layer of latex down, then soak the fibres, then stick it on top and then work it in with the paintbrush or the handle with the handle of the paintbrush. So we'll let that set and I'll do another video after this one, making the fibreglass mould and, like I say, casting and paint jobs. Right, so there it is, pretty much dry. And like I say, we'll come back in another video and make the mother mould. So it's around about the end of August 2017 at the moment. So I'll get this done over the next few days or possibly week. So the mother mould, that is. So there we are. Cheers then. Bye.